वेलकम टू डी एस ई जे होम क्लासेस एन अटेम्प्ट टू कनेक्ट लर्नर विद इंस्ट्रक्टर ए डिजिटल इनिशिएटिव बाय डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ स्कूल एजुकेशन जम्मू मायसेल्फ सावर हुसैन टीचर डिस्ट्रिक्ट पुंछ. Dear students, we are going to read a very beautiful poem from your English text Tulip series, book 10. The name of the poem is My Mother at 66, written by Kamala Das. Hope you will listen carefully. Before I start, let us have an introduction about the poet. At a time when women were considered commodities to be exchanged from their maternal home to their husbands about, Kamala Das came to a writer and poet who betrayed a woman as a human with feelings, desires, and pain, just like men. This fiercely vocal and opinionated writer was none other than our very own Kamala Suraiya, known to her Malayalam fans as Madhavi Kutty, to her English readers as Kamala Das. Kamala Das was born in 1934 in Malabar, Kerala. She is recognized as one of the India's foremost poets. Her works are known for their originality, versatility, and the indigenous flavor of the soil. Kamala Das has published many novels and short stories in English and Malayalam under the name Madhavi Kutty. Some of her works in English include the novel Alphabet of Lust, 1977, a collection of short stories, 1992, in addition to 5 books of poetry. Kamala Das embraced Islam in 1999 and since then was Suraiya. But later, she reverted again. Kamala Das has received many awards for her literary contribution. On May 31, 2009, aged 75, she died at a hospital in Pune. She is a sensitive writer who captures the complex subtleties of human relationships in lyrical idiom. My Mother at 66 is such an example. This poetry of Kamala Das consists of 20 lines in total, means a single thought is extended throughout the poem. These lines are not divided into stanzas. Here, they are divided into meaningful segments in order to make the poem easy to follow and understand. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me, doused, open-mouthed, her face ashen like that of a corpse, and realized with pain that she was as old as she looked, but soon. Explanation of the poem. First, when the poet is on her way to Cochin Airport from her parents' home last Friday morning, in these lines the poet says that she was observing her mother who was sitting beside her, had fallen asleep with her mouth slightly open, with pale face, and it reminded her of a dead body. The mother of the poet with the dozing face and open mouth is compared to a corpse. It is then she comes to realize that her mother had become very old with her age. And this was very painful for the poet to accept, and so she determined to focus her attention on something else. But soon put that thought away and looked out at young trees sprinting, the merry children spilling out of their homes. In these lines, the poet turned away from her aging mother and start looking outside the window of the car. The trees seemed to be running past the moving car. The sprinting of trees symbolizes the rapidly passing years of human's life from childhood to old age. This image, which shows activity and strength, is contrasted with that of her weak and old mother inside the car. In this poem, the sprinting trees signify the vitality of youth. The poet's eyes also fell on the children who were coming out of their houses, brimming over with their excitement to get outside, symbolize life, youth, and vitality. The poet here reminded of her own childhood when her mother had been young, whereas now she is encircled with the fear of losing her, and that has made her insecure. But after the airport's security check, standing a few yards away, I again looked at her wan, pale. The poet passed all these sights and reached the airport. Till then, her mind was distracted by the sights. However, after the security check, she was standing a short distance away from her mother, and again she chanced to notice the old woman. I looked again at her, wan, pale as a winter's moon, and felt that old familiar ache, my childhood's fear. But all I said was, "See you soon, Amma." All I did was smile and smile and smile. In these last lines of the poem, she compared her mother's colorless and pale face to the sight of the moon towards the end of the winter. This made her recall the things she had been most afraid of during her childhood, the fear that her mother would die one day. However, she did not let her fear show itself on her face. Instead, she put a brave face and waved goodbye to her mother. She assures her mother that they would be seeing each other again soon, and all the while she was in great agony. The smile never left her face. Theme of the poem: aging. The theme of the poem is aging, which is the eternal law of nature. Everyone has to change one day, and therefore the poet has portrayed the constraints on an old age which she found in her mother. On the earth, whenever a human being is born, he she has to grow up and face different situations that put in front by life. Mother-daughter relation. Kamala Das had a very close relationship with her mother. One of the many childhood fears she had was that she would be separated from her mother and that her mother would die. This made her insecure and worried. She is painfully aware that her mother is very lonely and doesn't have long to live, and finds it hard to accept the idea and wishes against all hope to see her mother soon and bids her goodbye with the hollow smile. Thinking about the poem, why have the trees been described as sprinting? Answer: the young trees are personified in the poem. They seem to be running in the opposite direction when seen through the window of the moving car. By this, the poet wants us to understand the energy at young age. Why has the mother been compared to the late winter's moon? Answer: the mother has been compared to the late winter's moon because it is a symbol of the lost stage of life, and the mother is at her end also. It is a simile which is being used by the poet. Learning about the literary devices. The poet compares her mother to many things. Pick out two similes which reinforce this comparison. What is simile? Simile, this device is used when an overt comparison is made between two different things. Answer: the poet compares her mother's face with that of a corpse and also uses the word like while making that comparison. She again compares her mother with the moon in winter's time and also uses the word as while making this comparison. What images does the poet used to describe death in the poem? Answer: her ashen face is pale and lifeless like a corpse. The poet uses this image to describe death in the poem. Cite an example of one device of contrast that the poet uses in the poem. Answer: the poet presents a fine contrast of happy children with her old mother. The children spilling out of their homes represents power, action, energy, and carefree life. On the other hand, her mother is sick, pale, and wan like a corpse, so there is a good contrast of life and decay. Smile and smile and smile is a poetic device. What is it called? This poetic device is called repetition. Sometimes the words are repeated to give musical effect, and sometimes the repetition of some words present an image which lingers in our imagination for a long time. Here, the continuous smile of the poet gives an image that she is trying to hide her fear and ache. Thank you, students. Hope you have enjoyed the poetry of Kamala Das. And at the end, the same message: stay home, stay safe.